Hey there, I hope you guys are doing good. Today I want to share one of my practical experience which helps me to get the intuitions about how logarithmic scale is so important while doing the EDA part in data science project. This is very basic and you can find many other ways to get the intuitions about logarithmic, but I just want to share one of my experience. And whenever somebody is asking you in the interview that why you took logarithmic scale to show your data, something like this, right? So you can tell this example to them and trust me, it is very effective. So now you will be able to see that I have created two scales over here. One is natural scale, other is logarithmic scale, right? So as of now, logarithmic scale is blank. Natural scale has some values. And why these values are over here? Because we have given a data set. We have given a data set like 0, 1, 2, 4, something like this, right? In the real world example, you will be able to see that you have data points, right? So consider it as a data points of your data science project. I have put all these data into a natural scale, which is very basic. Now, what is my task? So task is to convert natural scale to logarithmic scale, right? So we will be converting natural scale to logarithmic scale and we will be seeing the usage of, or we will be getting the intuitions why it is so important for us. So now this is our task. I have already put all these data sets, data points in the natural scales. Whenever I say logarithmic scale, okay, so right now in this current example I'm talking about base 2. Now you will be able to see that I have put 2 over here. So it means that while converting natural to logarithmic scale, I will try to make all the data points in the power of 2. Okay, I will convert all the data points with the power of 2, right? If I convert 1 into the power of 2, so you will be able to see that it's kind of a 2 to the power 0. It's 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, and so on. And if I talk about 2 to the power 3. So now you will be able to see that our task is to convert natural log to logarithmic scale so that we will be able to see it's important. So now I have converted all the data points in the form of power of 2, right? So you can see over here. So let if just for a moment just skip this, and if I take 1, I have converted it into the power of 2, 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, and so on up to 2 to the power 3. And for these values, if you like, if you want to convert it into the power of 2, you will get some value which is in the points, right? Which will be in the points between 2 to the power 2 and 2 to the power 3. You can define it mathematically, okay, which will be very long, like which is out of this particular example. But yeah, you can convert it into the power of 2 and it will be very long decimal value, okay? So let's take this example, right? So you will be able to see that it's a 2 to the power 3 data point for me and I have to convert it into the logarithmic scale, right? So if I'll take log of base 2, 8, okay? So because what is 8? 8 is my data point, right? Actual data point. Can I write this in the form of 2 to the power? So it is similar to 2 to the power 3. 8 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. Alright, so now if you will see the logarithmic graph, so what log will do is log will take this exponent over here. So for 8, if you will see for 8, you will see that 3 is the value or a data point in logarithmic scale. Okay, so if you have drawn the natural log scale and you have a data point over here whose value is 8, right? And if you convert this natural log scale into this particular logarithmic scale, you will be able to see that its value is converted to 3, right? Because what log function is doing? Log function is just isolating. What log function is doing? Log function is isolating the exponent, right? So always remember, what log function is do? Log function just isolate the exponent, or you can say power. Okay, so when I say 8, it means 2 to the power 3, and if I take the log of 8, it means log of 2 to the power 3, and as per the definition of log function, it says that just extract or isolate the power. So here power is 3, right? This 3. Okay, so it will put inside the logarithmic scale, right? Let's take log of 2 to the power 2, which means 4, and it is similar to 2, so value will go over here. So now you will be able to see that 4 is equal to 2 in the logarithmic scale. If you will go down over here, so you will be able to find log of 2 to the power 1, right, which is equivalent to 2, okay, which is equivalent to 1 over here. So now you will be able to see that 1 is over here, right? Now again, if I consider like 2 to the power 0 base 2, 2 to the power 0, then you will be able to see that like according to the definition of log, you just isolating this particular power and putting into the logarithmic scale. So you will be able to see that it's a 0 over here, right? So you will be able to see that 1 here is equivalent to 0, 2 here is equivalent to 1, 4 equivalent to 2, and 8 equivalent to 3, right? So you can see the all the data points over here that which is ranging from 0 to 8, right? While taking the logarithmic scale, same data points are used in between 0 to 3, okay? So you can see we have compressed the scale, right? So let's assume that I have a point over here which is 0.5, and you will say that, okay, just make it to the logarithmic scale, right? So can I say that 0.5 is similar to half, right? It is similar to half, right? Okay, so now I have to convert it into a logarithmic scale. So what will be the value of half? Can I say that it is equivalent to 2 to the power 2 minus 1, right? And if I isolate the power, it means minus 1, right? So you will be able to see that my value is minus 1 over here, right? And you can take n number of values excepting 0 over here, because log 0 is like undefined or infinite, you can say, right? You cannot define the value of 0 over here. You have made a logarithmic scale, you have converted the natural scale into the logarithmic scale whose value is ranging from 0 to 3 and 0 to minus 3, and so on, like according to the data points it will increase or decrease, right? Basically you guys are doing over here, you have compressed the scale. What log function is doing, as I have told you, log function is isolating the exponent, right? Always remember what log function is doing. Log function just isolate the exponent. Whose exponent? 2 to the power, if we are taking log of 2, right? So you will be able to see that the space for the natural log over here. So if I go to the like this particular graph, or you can say scale, normal scale, you will be able to see that the space here for the natural scale is very big in comparison with the logarithmic scale, or I'll say that it's kind of a 8x lesser, right? You have, because you have compressed the scale by converting it into the logarithmic scale. So let me highlight some of the points of logarithmic scales and versus natural scale or natural number scale. So you will be able to see that, as I have told you, it takes, this is for natural scale, it takes a very large space, right, in the graph, okay, and it is taking very less space because logarithmic scale compressed all the data points, right? You will be able to see that the distance from 1 is not symmetric over here in the natural scale, because it is like 1, 2, 3 and so on, like 1, 2, 3 and then 6, 8, maybe 15, maybe 1000 you can take, right? So it is not symmetric. Always remember, the natural or the normal graph you took with the original data points, right? Whenever, whatever the data points is, you just plot it into the graph or natural graph or linear graph, so it will be not symmetric for you. But if you take the logarithmic scale, it is symmetric, right? Because I have compressed all my data points in between 0 to 3 or 0 to minus 3, the same scale, within the same scale and within the same range, right? And you can say that log scale is equidistance, right? Magnitude is equidistance. So all these values are equidistant from each other, irrespective of natural scale. You can see over here that you can take the next value is 1000 over here. But if you convert it into over here, it will be more equidistant. So this is how logarithmic scale always works for us, right? So now when to use this graph? So if I just let me write over here, like magnitude is equidistant. Okay, so always remember, this is for log scale and this is for natural scale or linear, or you can say any graph. You put your original data points in the graph and see, because it won't be a symmetric one. It takes a very large space in the graph to show, and when to use this particular log scale. So whenever you have to show some trend, okay, trend like stock market, okay, so you can very well use this graph. So always remember, use log scale when we talk about fold changes. And what do you mean by fold changes? When we talk about fold changes, right? So what is the meaning of fold changes? Fold changes describes how much quantity changes, like how much quantity changes with respect to other quantity, right? Like I have told you, like if you want to see the trend of a stock market, like price and like today, tomorrow and so on per year, okay, 2020, right? So it will be like this. It is almost a straight line, okay? But if you will take a natural scale, so it will be like this, right? So it is very hard to read, right? But if you will see the logarithmic scale, so I'll show you the example of it. So you will be able to see that this guy is showing the years, and this is the price maybe, right? And it is the, you know, this is basically a linear scale. You will be able to see that the trend is going down and then up. It is not a kind of a straight line, right? Almost a straight line, not perfect straight line. But if you convert this particular graph into the logarithmic one, you will be able to see that all the things are basically in the equal distance, and it is not going that much down, right? Because the log scale puts positive and negative fold changes on a symmetric scale, right? So you can see, like for 25 it is going down then up. So but here you will see that like for the example I have shown you, 25 becomes something in something compressed form in the logarithmic scale, right? So this is the reason it is not going so much down. So yeah, so this is how you can show the or utilize the power of logarithmic scale. And whenever somebody is asking you in the interview, you can very well tell them that it is compressing the data. I'm using this compressed term from my own. Don't think it's a like terminology. So I'm basically compressing the large amount of a data into a small one. That's it. Guys, please do subscribe my channel if you like my content, right? And I'll be coming the NLP videos very soon. Thank you.